Good morning. This is the morning of the fourth day in Thailand. Yesterday we went to Koh Lat and saw a couple temples out there. We got back late last night. It was 11:30-ish, and after I repacked my bags because we decided to pay for a bag for Air Asia, which is the main airlines we'll be flying from Bangkok to Chiang Rai, and then from Chiang Rai we're going to drive to Chiang Mai, and then from Chiang Mai we're going to fly down to Phuket. But there's going to be a lot of flying, and because it's a budget airline, they charge you for every little thing, so hopefully we can get on with minimal luggage fees, or like if you're carry-on, i.e. this guy is overweight, they might charge you a fee. And there's going to be a lot of driving coming up, so all right, we're just going to prep and get ready and go to the airport, I believe. It is 5:20 in the morning right now, and I'm quite sleepy. I think I'm going to sleep in the car ride over to the airport, and then I'm going to sleep on the plane on the way up to Chiang Rai. More in a moment. So, it is now about 6 a.m. We've reached Don Mueang Airport, and we are at the check-in terminal. We're just waiting for, just to check in, just waiting in line. We have to turn in some luggage, so it is going to be a bit of a wait. If you are taking Air Asia or Milk Airlines, it's highly recommended that you get here early, particularly if you have to check in luggage. We'll see what happens here. I don't think we're going to have any issues. I'm hoping not. Knock on wood. But we'll see what happens. This is the old international airport, Don Mueang. This is Air Asia. We're going to Chiang Rai. It's an airport called Mathalong. And we're gonna rent a car, start going around. I believe we're going to a tea garden today and into the mountains. So it's pretty steep, but we'll see if the car can make it. We rented a Honda Civic kind of wannabe. I don't actually think it's a Honda Civic. It's called the Honda City. We'll see it in a moment here though. So they're boarding and it looks like we're almost done here. So yeah, more in a moment. Alright, so we've landed in Chiang Rai, and there's nothing in the cup. We've landed in Chiang Rai.
That engine's hella loud.
I guess we don't get gate service like the other planes do. But yeah, we're here. The weather is great. It's obviously very sunny. Gonna grab my sunglasses. Gotta go check out the car now. And look for the luggage. I guess this is how the luggage. Gets into the gate. I guess I'll check in a moment here.
Alright, well, got the suitcase. Now it's time to go get the car. Oh. I wonder if I wasn't supposed to be filming in there. Yeah, because it's a restricted area. Oops. They're nice about it. Anyways, more in a second. We're going to go ahead and grab our car. Checking the car. And we've made it to a place called Bandam in Chiang Rai. It is this right here. Pretty impressive, actually. Really cool thing. It's free to get in. There's no cost. So I would say that's definitely something that Thailand's doing right. Reminds me of how Hong Kong had the free museums to get in. So this place is actually quite huge, Bandam, that is. There's actually quite a lot of buildings here too. From the main house, you exit, and you come through, it's really nice and cool. A lot of these other buildings you actually cannot enter, so we were kind of wondering why the buildings are black, or what influences create the design. And we've made it to our second destination of Chiang Rai, which is a little place called Lai Chui Fong Tea Plantation. Oh, I might need to repark the car, actually, looking at it now. I'm just going to grab my camera real quick, try to get to the platform over here, and show you the reason why we came out to a tea plantation in Thailand. So, more in a moment. And this is that promised view. We are standing on a coffee shop right now. That over there is a restaurant. The entrance to the coffee shop, I don't know, let's see. If you can see, the coffee shop is right below us under the platform. The entrance is actually right here. And so everything you have to walk down into, there's actually, it's really, really awesome. Super, like, futuristic, I would say. Or it feels that way. So you walk in there, and you walk down, and that's a coffee shop. Over here, right by where we're parked, there is a bathroom or a restroom, which obviously you can't see because, oh, there you go, that guy right there is walking down into it, but that's where the toilets are. And awesome enough, everything is super clean here. So the weather is great, everything's clean. All right, we're gonna go to the restaurant, so I'll check in again in a second. All right, so we are now at the restaurant. To our next destination, Doi Chang Mub. And as you can see behind me, we are at the border of Thailand and Myanmar. And that, over on the other side of the fence right there, is Myanmar. And it's cool because you can see like a little farm right there. Oop. And a little village right there. So, and then just mountains that just seem to go on forever. So, pretty awesome. And we are standing in a military base. There's a trench right here and a ton of these little pillboxes. Which here, this is probably a better view of one. And you go into the trench if you want. Walk around. Get a view outside of the pillbox from the inside of the pillbox. Here's the trench. And here's the sign for the place.
For the respect of the Lama 9. That's number 9. That's number 9. Huh. In Thai. The bottom fit. The base of Doi Chang Mub.
Oh. Is that north, Mom?
Yeah. Oh.
I see. Well, I was wondering if this arrow was just pointing north or if it was pointing to Myanmar, like fire that way. All right, but yeah, that's pretty much it. Up there is just a barracks with more soldiers. So yeah, pretty amazing place. All right. More in a moment. So, we've made it to the Doi Tung Royal Pavilla, and we're actually at the bazaar right now, which is why you're seeing all these crazy fruits, vegetables, whiskey, fish sauce. This is actually the bazaar. I don't know if that actually will come out in the sun. Doi Tung Bazaar. There's toilets down there if you need them. Alright, well, more in a moment. So, we're actually at the first exhibit hall now that we're supposed to see here in Doi Tung. Because the king just recently passed away, everything is actually free currently, so this is the Hall of Inspiration. We'll be right back. We are at Ma Pha Luang Garden in Chiang Mai.
Chiang Rai.
And this is the second part of the area that you're supposed to see when you come here in Doi Tung. It's very famous. We already saw the Hall of Inspiration, and now we are at the garden. And just checking it out, it was 50 baht to get in, so just a little over a dollar US. And it is, as you can see, pretty amazing. Alright, more in a moment. So we're doing some treetop walking. Check it out. Might notice I'm no longer at Doi Tung Gardens. The battery of the GoPro actually ran out before I was able to finish, and I left the rest of the batteries, like a genius, in the car. So that's ours, no more footage of that. And now I'm here in the middle of downtown Chiang Rai looking at this clock tower, which perform on every hour, kind of musical and light show. I just watched, but I'll put it after this segment so that you guys can see it as well. So it was quite cool. Weather here is just amazing. It doesn't feel like you're in Thailand at all. More in a sec. Made it to the Chiang Rai Night Bazaar, and it's kind of like any other night market in Asia, I would say. It reminds me a little bit of Temple Street Market. I mean, of course it has a Thai feel to it. There's definitely not that many people here. There are probably more things that could hurt you here too, if you're not careful. Like just now, there was a hole in the ground, and I could totally tripped on it if I wasn't paying attention. Looks good though. They have all sorts of goods here. Bazaar I've been to in Thailand, I would say this has always been the best part, is the food. Shopping's okay. My mom is actually shopping right now because she forgot her luggage at the airport, and that's a whole different story. She's actually run a little light on clothes, whereas I'm a little hungry, so I guess I'll look at the food. Thank you. follows pretty much all the stalls. They, I have to say, this one's kind of more similar than I'm used to. They all look kind of the same. But I would also say that there are not nearly as many people here as I thought there would be. I mean, if we just take a quick glance, it's pretty empty. I mean, I guess so is most of the bazaar, though. But we look, yeah, all these empty tables. These guys are closed up. Perhaps it's just not as cracking as like Hong Kong is, or we just came. I mean, it is a Tuesday night, so perhaps tonight's not the party night to come out to a night bazaar. But there are plenty of stalls that are open with all sorts of weird, unique things that you could get here. Oh, looks like I ran into Mom again. Just now that weird laugh was some lady thought I was filming her, but I'm actually filming me, so she was posing, and then she realized she was looking at me via my camera, which I guess would be kind of funny. But, yeah. So, alright, I guess unless I see something cool, I'll check in a moment.